are going to get stunned, knocked back by the Taliyah, and instantly killed.
And even then, it almost has to be premeditated, right? Because it's a point-and-click stun from the Pantheon, but if they know where you are, Taliyah will deal damage anyway. If you're in the Shroud, she can still land the flick, the Q's still going to hit you in the head, and the damage will still be there, so... yeah, as you mentioned, a lot of risk here, but very differing styles. This is a very different draft than what we've seen from...
G4 there to miss the spear, although now we see... outside the hook follow-up, that might just be enough. The Ignite is going down. Dio's running for his life. The Kai's in the flash forward. He's got to get it. I love
the hook. Hook misses.
Support. Now Pop not going to be able to make it on safety. They're slowly trying to burn him down. Does Syndra have the cooldowns to make this happen? Pop running for his life.
Nothing will come his way.
All right, instant stun comes in, blocks the follow-up damage. Of course, has the next ability will be empowered, and I see no. Oh, the instant flash!
Yes,
got huge.
So much sense.
I mean, look, we're already seeing a 10 CS discrepancy. You've got the serrated dirk, you've got the corrupting potion, very easy lane, and now he's on the top side of the map. Are they gonna go for this? He leaps in, gonna block as much damage as possible. Pantheon tanky, but he just doesn't take anything back. Hani now running for his life. The sweep is there, can't sidestep it. Rocky's gonna walk away.
Yeah.
Camille now able to force the lane in with the Tiamat. But as you mentioned, Ocean Drake in the sights of both teams. Decent defensive vision set up from the side of MG, but not really enough that's gonna allow them access to pick comfortably.
Flash,
easy, the follow-up. G4 can't block it all, and that's gonna be the Luden's Echo before he has enough kill pressure to find anything here.
Mm-hmm. And just very good preparation. Artifact actually baiting this one, thinking for the reset, and G4 was just posturing around the wall. Like
DNK can still come. Smite is up and available.
Bottom lane's rotating already. Venus and Celebrity will be here long before the Kai'Sa can at all. Rocky's in.
The Lee Sin locked up. DNK, though, now just going to get finished off. The Riptail has reset. Celebrity on the way. What can he get done? The Syndra stun not going to connect. Tawny coming in as well, but the GP does not have enough items to be a massive threat. Lloyd going to walk away with a sliver of health, but Artifact is on the hunt. Venus will go down on one side, Lloyd on the other, and Rocky has stayed too long. Gets taken out in the end. That's the 2-for-1.
Yeah, and
global, but very long-range ultimate. You have to assume that they'd be very good at punishing any kind of 1-3-1 setup, but just have not seen it whatsoever. DNK, though.
Stun's on.
Fishing
Q's on.
He's gonna hit on the Lloyd. Boy cannot survive, and now Pantheon's all on his lonesome. Celebrity flashing out. The Syndra's still alive, but the rest of the team now moving in. The Kai'Sa has joined. The shutdown is there for Rocky. He's fishing for a little bit more. The threat locked up, sure to be taken out, but Artifact, Conqueror now proc. Conqueror activated. Fishing for Daewoo. A good flash out, but it's not going to be enough. Daewoo taken down in the end as Pop now has to run for his life. Loki are just gonna clean him up here. No hope left for the Nautilus. Taken down by Hani in the end.
Themselves the crab looking for the blue steal away, but Pop is in the area. Can he stop this one?
Is he gonna try to grab
it? Oh, he gets it.
Lee Sin locked up a good amount of CC, but the barrel's there. It's not even going to matter. Can't click the lantern whatsoever. Good.
Yeah, doesn't want to stick around. Doesn't have too much vision in the bot side jungle, though, if anybody is following. Of course, Lloyd.
Hook goes
in the camp right now. Okay.
The wall. Celebrity's gonna try to find it, but it's Celebrity caught in the midst of the team. A perfect use of the Kai'Sa ult is going to save his life, and he gets taken down, biting off way more than he can.
Not by anyone, all 10 members just start rotating to the play. And they clean up Celebrity, now Mega, still looking for more.
Artifact dashing out, good buffer there, now pulling in the Pantheon, deleted. Huge barrel and a kick to finish.
In forwards, Lloyd has made his way up here. Point and click stun lands.
Artifact now going to try to retreat. Now goes in on Lloyd. Sees an opportunity to finish off a very squishy target. He
gets
one, and he's just going to look for two. Artifact is on the hunt. G4 is not enough. A double kill. It's too clean.
And Loki in a very good spot. Let's take another look at what actually happened. Mega are baiting this one. They have the pink ward, but unfortunately the CC isn't still around when Lloyd arrives. And that is the combo. CC into flick back, and Artifact recognizes the opportunity, goes forward, uses everything, cleans them up with ease. No
execute well.
Mm-hmm. Top side. Hook goes out. He's going to land.
Next to the Pantheon now pulls it back with the Nautilus. Going to pitch for the re-engage. G4 now goes forward, but instantly taken out as a support on the opposite side. Zhonya's the first one used. Rocky steps forward. The timing is a little bit off. And escape
gets
is
it.
Not going to happen. Akathy and Rain will take him down, and now the Akali has been locked up, caught in the midst of it. It is a Hextech ultimatum. The ultimatum going to be death, and the long, slow goodbye as the triple kill comes in for the Kai'Sa.
He's big. He can get it done, but only one person to deal with. Rocky once again looking for the side lane. We saw it before.
Getting caught out. Could be a massive pick. Boy Seeker comes in. Now there's the team trying to fish. Taliyah's there to make sure no one else can follow, and that's going to be the single pick onto the likes of Hani. Now G4 steps forward. Artifact has stayed way too long. It's there. Can he grab his way out? No, he has to leap out to save the Artifact. Pulling back.
Use it.
I thought you were going to bring us back to football.
not quite. He lands a W on the back end of this fight, and a very nice stopwatch from Hani, but in terms of abilities to get on the Kai'Sa, it is just incredibly difficult, and every time Mega finds themselves in one of these situations, Loki just cannot access the Kai'Sa, and it's going to continue getting harder and harder as the game progresses.
You see the setup.
But they don't see it.
They don't see it.
Oh no, Lloyd.
Little dramatic irony for our boy Lloyd.
G4,
here.
No.
Not like this. Oh my god, instantly they're going to delete him. That's going to be an easy pick. The Death Brush finds its first victim. The kick follow-up will not be there, though. Artifact could start to fish. Dash is over with the first charge of the ultimate, but now looks like Rocky sees an opportunity to go all in on Hani. DNK now fishing, trying to charge for a little bit more. Going in on Deloitte, and Artifact jumping into the backside. Deo in his sights. That's so much damage to the shield. He's waiting for it to fade. But no, the knockup comes in from the Nautilus. Pop now flashing out to safety, but DNK continues the chase. Big damage traded back, but not enough. Now it's going to be complete and clear access to the Baron from the side of low key.
And it's two picks enough to take this one down. G4 or GP Hani in the side lane.
Dodging as much as he can, but Hookshot Wall Dive is all it's going to take. The flash out not going to be enough. Precision Protocol will finish the kill. The Hookshot takes him to safety.
And is Baron still now an option? You can see the reset coming through potentially from Artifact. He has to deal with Camille if he stays in the play, but he doesn't. He resets. Baron buff, half HP.
They don't have an AD carry. They do so little damage. This is taking too long. Loki need to get out of the pit. Deo is now coming in. They're all going to get wiped if they stay for too long. Rocky now in the midst of the entire team. They need to get Deo out, but this is a Kaisa's dream. If Artifact doesn't finish this kill, it could turn. It's all on Artifact. Can he take Deo out?
He
will get the shutdown. That's massive for Loki. And the resurrection comes in for Rocky, but he's in the midst of the pit. Now G4 is on the hunt. The Pantheon, the Grand Starfall.
Oh, he's dead!
The triple kill. Celebrity gets one back, but no, the shutdown. G4 needs to finish it. I don't think he can do it. The Pantheon, the Empowered on, has the double kill. Artifact, he's continuing. He wants the challenge. He wants it, and he's gonna get it. Artifact takes out G4.
Fights all over the place. The game's just back to even.
And you look at this fight, and I mean, we have to once again give credit to Artifact here. Because at the end of the day, Dale, this is a dream for him.
Mm-hmm.
A single Akathian rain in that pit. He's getting two kills, but Artifact makes sure it cannot happen.
Yeah, started off with almost the bait there from DNK. Q lands onto Kaisa, throws it back, and Dale is like chasing the kill forward. He sees the opportunity, but Shroud down early. Surprising that Rocky just instantly dies. Celebrity one taps him off the back end. If Camille got into melee range, hits the Syndra, that's a triple kill waiting to happen, but able to be salvaged there from Mega.
And repeat, farm your lanes, let's go right back to the pit.
Yeah, potentially. The good thing, okay.
DNK, that's massive. Jungler dead instantly. Perfect start now for Mega. They need to start this one off. A lot of pick potential for low key, though.
And do they just straight up want to start the Baron? Vigil Control on the top side jungle. Waves pushing in. I was going to say good thing for low key because they now have TP advantage, but that pick on the jungler as well just completely wipes the floor. Baron's up.
No ulti, of course, for the Kaisa, but steadily coming back off cooldown. 6k and getting lower. She shreds the Baron. This should be an easy pickup. Can they find the steal? Can they get it in
Hook?
The end? Mega now coming in. Massive Pantheon ult. They're just going to clean up this fight. It's too easy. Dale not going to get locked down. Rocky making sure Artifact can't get anything else done. The AD carry is still alive. Mega are wiping the floor with low key. They're making it look so easy as Hani just runs for his life. Nothing left for him. Mega playing with their food a little bit. The ult comes off cooldown. They proc this one. The GP maybe hoping to fish for a kill. This could be a difference maker. Hani now needs to be careful. Brayseeker's going to give it to him. Dale gets it. Mega just going to run straight down the mid lane.
And that's exactly what they needed. The perfect combo of the team fight already picking up the Baron buff. Base broken. DNK is up, but it's 30 seconds on a relevant carry. This is going to be incredibly hard to defend here from Loki.
Lee Sin's going to need a miracle kick if he wants to buy enough time for the rest of his team. Getting lower and lower. It feels like this just has to be it, Ejim. Mega moving in, making up for their mistakes early in the day. And here versus low-key esports and the VCS, they'll find their first win.
And in almost just exactly the game